Hospital and Research Center in Mumbai. I'm Dr. Swati Kanankia. I'm a pediatric hematologist oncologist from Mumbai. I have a PhD in thalassemia and more than 20 years of experience, actually 25, of treating and diagnosing and managing children with thalassemia. Today is World Thalassemia Day, which is the 8th of May, and we are doing this video to create awareness about thalassemia, and we want that more and more people come to know about this disease because it's a very preventable disease.
Welcome, ma'am. Can you please help us understand what is thalassemia?
So, thalassemia is basically a blood disorder. In this disorder, the hemoglobin is not correctly formed. Let us say that it is a little defective, and therefore the person is anemic. That means the hemoglobin is less. There are different forms of thalassemia, some of which are very mild, and they are almost normal people. And the most severe form of thalassemia is thalassemia major, where as the name suggests, it's a severe and a serious disease.
Ma'am, as you're discussing about major and minor thalassemia, can you help us understand these terms better?
So basically thalassemia is of two types. It's called as the alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia. Alpha thalassemias, I won't say are rare in India. Since the tests are now available, we are seeing and diagnosing more and more people with alpha thalassemia. Today we'll talk about beta because that is really a public health problem in our country. Beta thalassemia is broadly speaking classified into three types. The thalassemia minors are the ones which are extremely asymptomatic. They are very normal. They are people like me, like you. It could be anyone who is walking on the streets. They're as normal as that. Thalassemia major are those children who have the severest form of beta thalassemia. They inherit two defective genes from both the parents. So one defective gene from each parent, and they are not able to form hemoglobin well at all. And therefore, they require blood transfusions throughout life just to sustain themselves, just to live, just to survive. With the blood transfusions that we give them, there are a lot of other complications. The most important one is iron overload, and that iron has to be removed from the body with the help of other medicines. So it is actually a very problematic disease. And thalassemia intermedia, as the name suggests, comes in between thalassemia minor and major. It's not that severe. These children do not require blood transfusions every monthly like the thalassemia major. But we see that invariably they start behaving like thalassemia major with the same kind of complications and the same kind of clinical scenarios. Of course, we treat them with hydroxyurea, which is one medicine, and they do pretty well.
Ma'am, can you help us know what is the occurrence of thalassemia in our country?
So, beta thalassemia, the minor form, so it's the same, like we use these terms synonymously, thalassemia minor, thalassemia, a carrier of beta thalassemia, or thalassemia trait. These three terms are used interchangeably. In certain communities, like the high-risk communities, the Sindhis, Punjabis, Kachi Luhana, Panushali, the Bengalis, where they have hemoglobin E disease. We also see it in Hindu Marathas, Agri community, and a lot of Muslims, because they have consanguineous marriages. We see a lot of beta thalassemia trait. In fact, in some communities, one in every five person would be carrying that trait. and therefore it is imperative for people to get themselves tested. The amount of thalassemia major throughout the world is estimated at 1 lakh. In India, it is 10,000 a year, and that is a huge amount. It may not sound that much when you're thinking in terms of, you know, millions and crores of people, but for these 10,000 children and their families, it can be pretty severe and devastating.
Ma'am, you just said that it is imperative to get oneself tested for thalassemia. Can you help us understand why?
So basically, by testing for thalassemia minor, the whole aim is to prevent the birth of a thalassemia major child. See, the treatment for thalassemia major is there. We give them blood every 15 days, every 21 days, but that is not treatment. We are just trying to alleviate the symptoms and then so many other complications. There are other methods, like you can say bone marrow transplant. It is there, people are doing it. But bone marrow transplant is expensive. Sometimes, see, just like a blood donor, you need somebody who will donate bone marrow to you. Okay, so bone marrow donors have to be a matched sibling or a matched parent, for example, or it could also be someone who is unrelated to the parent, but to the child. But all this comes at a huge cost. And of course, bone marrow transplant is not simple. It's not like, you know, you do it and you walk out. It is a difficult form of therapy. So I truly believe that it is a preventable disease, and that's what we should do. We should work towards it.
Ma'am, who all can get themselves tested for thalassemia?
Okay, so as I said that people from high-risk communities have to get themselves tested, and I mentioned them a little earlier. I've done a PhD, and in all the patients that I saw, I've come across very strange communities who also have thalassemia, which we had never heard of before. The Gujaratis, the Jains, some Maharashtrians, I mean, it could be just anyone. So my sincere request would be that every one of us should get ourselves tested. It's a very simple blood test. There is nothing really major in it, and the cost of the test, you ask me, is the money that you spend on maybe ordering food from Swiggy or from any of the the different eateries, or it could be equivalent to money spent on watching a film at a multiplex. So all of us should get ourselves tested. That's the first thing. Definitely people from the high-risk communities. If you know by chance that your spouse has thalassemia or your partner has thalassemia minor, you must get yourself tested for thalassemia. If you have anemia, which is not responding to iron, okay, the doctor has given you medications, they've given you iron, folic acid, vitamin B12, and yet you are not reaching, a good hemoglobin level, definitely test yourself for thalassemia minor. To my, from what I would like to say is that each and every pregnant lady must get themselves or must get herself tested for thalassemia minor. It is just like I would request all my fellow gynecologists, all my gynecologist friends to include this as their basic testing in all patients who are pregnant.
Are there any treatment available for thalassemic patients?
You mean thalassemia minor?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, of course. So please understand that it is a genetic disease, so we can't really correct it. But if you do have anemia, we can give you some supplements like folic acid that may be helpful. We can suggest that you don't take iron, because iron, you'll just overload the iron in the body and cause problems. So we would not like to give you more iron. Having said that, I find that in India, some patients, despite being thalassemia minor, would have iron deficiency as well. So we try and correct the iron deficiency and then stop giving the iron. We advise some dietary changes, that means avoiding foods which are very rich in iron. So these are some lifestyle modifications, but please understand, patients with thalassemia minor can be completely normal. The biggest and the first question that all patients ask me is that, can my child participate in sports? Can my child lead a normal life? And the answer to that is yes. They may not be able to do some very strenuous activities, but I have one patient who was a thalassemia minor, and he used to swim in the sea from Gateway of India to Ural. I mean, this is how normal a person can get with thalassemia minor.
As we are educating the common people about, you know, why, what, how about thalassemia, we had got queries from the doctors, the general physicians, that any message you have, being a specialist in this field, any message for them in case if they, you know, happen to treat or meet a thalassemic patient?
So my message to the doctors is that a CBC report is one of the simplest things that we get our patients to do. I mean, almost everyone gets a CBC, that is a complete blood count, at some point or the other. So what are the flags? What is something that you should watch out for a patient who has come with a CBC report for, let us say, a cough cold? So the hemoglobin may be marginally low. Sometimes, trust me, it is not low. I've had thalassemia minor patients at 14 grams of hemoglobin. The other thing is the RBC count, okay? An RBC count which is high and persistently high should definitely trigger the doubt of thalassemia. And the third point is microcytosis. That means the red cells are small in size. So this is the third pointer. And the last one, before I go on to the last one, the microcytosis is pretty severe. So if it is a severe microcytosis, which cannot, you know, it generally doesn't correspond to the iron levels, in that case definitely think of thalassemia. And the last parameter is RDW. If your patient is not iron deficient, okay, in that case the RDW will be normal. So just keep this in mind, that you have a low or normal hemoglobin, you have a high RBC count, there is microcytosis, and the RDW is normal. This is the magic mantra for detecting thalassemia minor in any person or any patient who comes to your clinic for, you know, just about anything. Having said that, we have seen patients, in fact we are seeing more and more patients, where you do a hemoglobin electrophoresis and you realize that this child doesn't have beta thalassemia trait, but the child continues, or the person continues to be anemic or continues to have an high RBC count. Please test for alpha thalassemia. This is what we are picking up more and more, and with the availability of tests, we find that a lot of these unexplained cases, or the so-called refractory cases to iron, are in fact alpha thalassemias.
Ma'am, one last question from our viewer. He would like to know the facilities available at Lilavati Hospital for treating thalassemic patients.
So at Lilavati, we are able to offer comprehensive care. We have pediatric hematologists, we have adult hematologists who are dedicated